Hello everyone and welcome to Mountain Lake Journal. I'm Tom Halleck. This month, nearly 200 volunteers will be heading to the summits of the high peaks and neighboring mountain ranges of New England in search of 10 migratory songbirds that nest in some of the highest elevations of those mountains and the Adirondacks. The data they collect from 130 trails and locations will help researchers working to protect those songbirds, including the elusive and rare Bicknell's thrush. Their nesting grounds here in the Northeast in the summer and winter home in the Caribbean are under threat from pollution, development, and increasingly many worry, climate change.
The first pole set, just gonna run it out, keeping tension on it. To the other end, it's 12 meters long.
Biologist Chris Rimmer with the Vermont Center for Ecostudies spends summers high atop Mount Mansfield, setting up these nylon nets.
We're trying to learn basically about the health of the bird populations that nest on these mountaintops.
And while the nets capture several types of migratory songbirds that live in these alpine forests, they are looking for one bird in particular.
The Bicknell's thrush is one of the most rare species of songbirds in eastern North America, about 100,000 or so in the world. It's a vulnerable community of birds. These habitats are vulnerable to many different factors from, climate change especially, but atmospheric pollution, acidic precipitation, mercury, development from ski areas being rare, and then living in a vulnerable habitat, we're concerned about it.
After hours of catching warblers and an unhappy robin,
robins complain more than some other species.
Rimmer finds a prized catch in the net.
This is our primary quarry, the wily and rare Bicknell's thrush.
Rimmer and his team study these migratory songbirds not only here in the mountaintops where they nest and spend their summers, but also a handful of islands in the Caribbean where they winter and where their native forests are under constant threat from development and now a changing climate.
The whole issue of climate change is the sort of overlaying threat that we're most profoundly worried about in the long term. You know, these habitats at both ends, in the north here and in the south there, are threatened by climate change, by a warming climate, which is predicted to push the mountaintop forests higher and higher, which is happening.
With warming temperatures, the balsam fir forest in the high peaks and northeast mountain ranges where the Bicknell's nest may begin to shrink.
The hardwood forests, which are sort of the lower end of these coniferous mountaintop forests, are encroaching upslope. I mean, there is empirical evidence that that is occurring. Some species that are more typical of lower elevations are beginning to creep up, like Swainson's thrush, maybe yellow-bellied flycatcher.
Have we seen anything direct? Not yet. There's been some discussion about, and some, you know, anecdotal observations by us and others of things like Swainson's thrush, very closely related to Bicknell's thrush, that there's more of them at higher elevations than there used to be. We don't have the hard data yet for that, but it does look like, to me, after 25 years of running around up there, that there are places where I did not have Swainson's thrushes that was too high up for them. They're sort of a lower elevation montane species, and they're mixing more, it seems, in some places with Bicknell's thrush. What will happen with that? How do they compete? There probably is going to be some competition there.
Getting a definitive answer could take years because Bicknells are so rare and elusive. What will help answer those questions is data being collected by teams of citizen scientists who are part of Mountain Bird Watch. Every June, these volunteers fan out across the Northeast to monitor Bicknells and 9 other migratory songbirds on 130 trails high in the mountaintops. Jason Hill is the director of the project.
Mountain Bird Watch has been invaluable to giving us insight into where we need to dedicate our effort over the next 10, 20 years. To document the effects of climate change on vertebrate species, you need long-term monitoring data set, like Mountain Bird Watch can do. And that's actually will become a big part of my focus over the next 2 or 3 years, is looking at elevational shifts in the birds that we monitor, and as well as latitudinal shifts. It's the center of their distribution moving northwards.
The volunteers have collected more than 20,000 observations over the past 20 years, which will help researchers like Chris Rimmer and Kent McFarlane answer questions about what impact climate change is having long-term on the Bicknell's thrush and other migratory songbirds that live in these alpine forests.
It's going to take a while to really understand what's happening. And, you know, we want to know if things are different in New York versus New Hampshire, which are the two areas that have the mother load of breeding Bicknell's thrush, the Adirondacks and the White Mountains.
This story is part of Peril and Promise, a national public media initiative from WNET in New York, exploring the impact of climate change here in the Adirondacks and around the world.